Cassie and Rita. My brother just went scuba diving, but I'm scared too. What's it like underwater? Signed, Jared. Well, Rita is more the scuba expert, but I do know that you have to be at least 12 years old to get certified. If you're not 12 yet, try snorkeling.
Oceans are the largest ecosystem on Earth. 70% of the Earth's surface is covered with them. The oceans connect and animals can move between them. One species may live in all the world's oceans. Ready?
The ocean has many different habitats. You can find sandy plains, mountains, coral reefs, and deep canyons, as well as open water.
The waters of the ocean, or pelagic habitat, are divided into three zones. The euphotic zone, from the surface down to 100 meters or so, gets enough sunlight to support colonies of tiny plants and animals called plankton. They may be microscopic, but they support just about every food chain in the ocean. The bathyal zone gets little or no light. There's no sunlight whatsoever in the abyssal zone, which can go down to 6,000 meters or more. The pressure down there is enough to turn you into a smooth paste, but there's still life down there.
The benthic habitat is what scientists call the ocean floor. This covers coral reefs to the continental shelves to underwater mountain ranges to deep ocean trenches. The deepest trench is the Marianas in the Pacific. It's over 11,000 meters deep, and you could lose the world's tallest mountains inside of it.
All of these zones support different types of sea life. They may look like rock, but coral reefs are actually made from the hard skeletons of small animals called coral polyps. Coral reefs are home to many underwater animals like eels, anemones, polyps, parrotfish, rockfish, and starfish. Reefs are close to the surface and sunlight penetrates their waters. They're like the rainforests of the sea.
On the ocean floor, you'll see sponges, sea mats, and sea squirts, creatures like lobsters and crabs, and bottom-feeding fish like halibut. In the depths of the ocean, it's so dark that no plants can grow, and fish have special light-emitting abilities. The anglerfish has a lighted rod on its head to attract prey. Freaky.
There are also vents down there, cracks on the floor of the Pacific where hot sulfuric gases gush out into the surrounding waters. Creatures living near these vents absorb the chemicals and convert them into energy.
Speaking of creatures, there are more than 21,000 known species of fish in the ocean. Fish are classified into two main groups, fish with jaws like tuna and mackerel and sharks, and fish without jaws like hagfish and lampreys.
Some fish with jaws have skeletons of cartilage, and others have bony skeletons.
Rita mentioned a food chain, just like the food chains you find on land. One organism is eaten by another, who is, in turn, eaten by somebody else. And so on.